I'm at least at back reporting.
But Joshua, I don't know. Yeah. He's an Olympic gold medalist, but I mean, I would probably pull for Wilder, but I'll have to edge out.
Why do you think the publicity for Wilder hasn't been big, considering he's an American champion? How come the American people have not really got behind him?
Boxing is accepted, I think, a little bit better across the pond. That's my take on it. I think the English fans are some of the best fans in the world.
And with that being said...
Back to your question, bro. All right, I got mixed up. Sorry.
No, I did too. You confused me, but I confused myself.
Sergio, with that being said, Eddie Hearn's been coming over here, Matchroom Boxing USA. He had a big signing. You faced him. Devin Jacobs, man, what do you think that partner is going to create here for boxing?
That was no coincidence. Eddie Hearns has plans of taking over and doing his thing over here, but we have our established promoters. I think it's only good for the sport, you know, him bringing that fan appeal from Europe and England and everything else. So it's only bigger and better for boxing. It's a great thing.
And obviously the big picture for Jacobs is fight against Gennady Golovkin and Canelo. You faced him. You fought his power. Well, how would Jacobs fare in there with Canelo? I know you fought Golovkin already, but Canelo.
Like I told Ellie earlier, I think Jacobs fights anybody at 160 and gives him problems. Just too big and strong. And Canelo, he's a big and strong guy too, and goes up to like 175 after winning, but I don't think he's a natural middleweight. Yeah. When he punches, he has explosiveness as a middleweight, but not compared to Jacobs. So I think Jacobs might have the edge on that one.
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter @Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram @EllieSekpak. Take a step back.